worry. It's just going to get better from here.
You said that in a very interesting manner that I'm not sure if I should believe you or not.
Episode 18.
Let's do it.
Community.
We're back.
All right, time to talk about basic genealogy.
I love genealogy.
You do?
I actually do. I actually was recently reached out to from a very distant cousin who was like, oh, I saw your DNA on the thing, which is kind of weird, but it's very interesting. And was like, oh, here's some details about your great-great-great-great-grandfather that you didn't know. And I was like, that is true. I didn't know that. That's very valuable information.
I know one of my relatives on the Titanic.
Oh, did they make it?
No.
Oh, that was a bummer. That was a sad one.
No, he, fell in love with this woman, and then they were on, a board at one point to try to save themselves, but then he wanted to save the girl, so then he, near, far, wherever you are. She promised never to let go.
It's a very detailed account.
No, as far as ancestors. I know, I think it was, a cousin. I think he was a crew member, so, his chances were low.
Very low. Oh, my God, that's really thank you, our community. Basic genealogy, let's do it.
I lost my train of thought. I made it up on the spot.
That was really good.
It's bad when you laugh at your own jokes.
It's fine. As long as we're all laughing.
All right, so anyway.
Ooh.
Oh, it's family day at Greendale.
It's family day.
What could go wrong?
When family is involved, everything.
Well, we watched Orphan Black, and there's a couple family days. Mm-hmm. So that went, and that always went well.
Right.
So that had clones. Speaking of which, so She-Hulk's a clone, right?
No.
Yes.
Not in the original comics.
No, but now it is because it's Tatiana Maslany, so it's a clone.
Oh, yeah. Well, I guess so. I guess so. That would make sense. I haven't watched the trailer. I saw a screenshot with the CG. Looked really weird. And I was like, I can't do this today.
I agree. But also, I love... But we love
Tatiana Maslany.
And I love her. And Mark Ruffalo.
Yeah, it's true.
Anyway.
They're trying me.
Basic genealogy.
Oh, I love genealogy.
Hey. Haven't seen you all day. Speaking of, I was going to invite my mom so you could meet her. But she still thinks I'm a lawyer.
Ha.
Oh, look. A human being has a little human with it. How blood-curdlingly adorable.
Jeff. We need to talk.
What's wrong? Are you breaking up with me?
Oh, maybe we don't need to talk.
Community, so it's family day, but before we get that up, Slater breaks up with Jeff.
Yeah, really quick. It's just a real quick, oh, by the way, we're done.
Bye-bye.
So long.
So that's it. And then Jeff seems okay.
Yeah.
Because he's just I didn't dump her.
Yeah.
So I got to, I don't have to, hide to, try to be sensitive. I'm just, I can do whatever I want.
Right.
But we talk about who's coming to family day, so Shirley's kids are coming. Mm-hmm.
My sister likes to joke that they don't recognize me anymore, and I like to joke that she's just jealous because she's barren.
Oh my God.
Dad's bringing my cousin Abra. Abra wears a full burqa in public, so she just looks like someone covered head to toe in black fabric.
Can't believe my grandma's rolling her old bones down here. I gotta pick a cabinet to hide in.
You hide from her?
Yeah. She's crazy.
Troy, society programs us to dispose of the elderly because they don't work or buy things, but don't be blind to your grandmother's value. You need to cherish her.
You cherish her.
I'm sure. No, but I will. You know,
I have a point.
Be around forever.
I want to believe you're right, Britta, but you never quite are you?
I think so. I think the people who don't have people coming are Jeff and technically Annie, but Annie's also not super, and Britta.
Yeah.
But Annie's also not super involved in the episode. She just kind of helps out a little bit with Jeff's plot line.
Right.
And then Abed's dad's coming.
Mm-hmm. With his cousin,
from Abra.
Gaza.
Yep. And then Troy's Nana's coming.
Yes.
And then, Troy has a thing of, saying, his Nana's crazy. Mm-hmm. And Britta's kind of you need to respect your elders. Don't say they're crazy. Mm-hmm. But I'm kind of on Troy's side as having several crazy relatives in my life. I'm if somebody says that their relative is crazy, they're correct.
Yeah, so I think Britta's was less about, don't call your relatives crazy. It was more,
respect your elders.
We disrespect seniors as a population, which is, fair. I have a lot of opinions about.
Yeah.
Because that's related to what I do for a living.
Well, yeah.
I do have opinions on
I
that.
I agree.
She has a point there, but at the same time, they can be crazy.
I agree with you, but also as somebody who had a crazy grandma at one point, I'm kind of if I say that they're crazy, they are.
That's true. That's fair. I give that to you.
Right. So those, everybody was coming, and then, not everybody, we'll get to that, but as they're, talking and stuff, They're also like saying like they're also trying to make Jeff feel better for the fact that he got dumped.
Mm-hmm. Actually, no, she dumped me.
Oof. Oh no, that's so sad. I'll give Jeff a shoulder to cry on, and you boys go put a dead bird in that bitch's glove compartment.
guys, sit. Surely, I don't.
Surely, is very ride or die.
Jeff, where are you?
I appreciate
friends?
That.
As the dumpy, I can start making out with every girl on campus right now, and all anyone will feel for me is sorry.
Ew, not anymore.
Your heart's desensitized, Jeff. You're like a machine. It feels no love, just sex. You're like the bootinator. You know the bootinator? Like, I'll be back, but with booty.
Why would the bootinator be back with booty? Wouldn't he just try and kill it?
Well, maybe he kills it, and then he brings it back as a trophy.
Why would he want dead booty?
Guys, I'll be back, but with booty.
Yeah. That's beneath you.
Gross.
And I do like the line because then as like they're talking and then Shirley kind of brings up Bootinator.
The whole Bootinator exchange is very funny.
And then Jeff kind of feels like a pretty girl. Mm-hmm. And then he's like, guys, I'll be back with booty. Mm-hmm. And then goes to meet this pretty girl who is.
I'm here for family day. I'm looking for my family.
Oh, well, I'm sure at the very least I could fill in for a creepy uncle. Jeff.
Amber.
There she is. Look at you all grown up.
I knew
up.
It.
Jeff, this is my stepdaughter, Amber.
Small world.
No, actually, it's a very big world with 5 billion other women in it. Mm-hmm. Good luck.
I'm back.
Without booty.
Now I feel sorry for you.
Oh, we find out her name's Amber, and it's Catherine McPhee, which I didn't realize for, like, a while.
Oh, okay.
But I think it's because, like, I'm used to seeing her as a brunette. Mm-hmm. And this is, like, she's, like, oh, it's, like, a blot. Like, it's, like, I think I've seen her, she's, like, a longish, or, like, sort of, like, maybe, like, this height, like, right. Brown hair. Mm-hmm. So it's sort of thing. And then it turns out that this is Pierce's family, a.k.a. his ex-stepdaughter.
Yes, because he has many ex-wives.
I think he has 7.
He has 7 ex-wives, and naturally some of them had children, so he has some stepchildren.
So, yeah, he doesn't have any biological children.
Correct.
But Jeff's kind of upset now because he's like, oh, I don't think I can bang her now.
Right.
Because, you know, but anyway. So we cut to Spanded Clutch and everybody's like, families are there. So we see Shirley's kids and they're just like kind of being like kids.
Hands in the air.
Who wants carrots?
Boys, leave that man alone. And that's Elijah, like the prophet, and Jordan, like the 14-time NBA All-Star.
Gubinader.
Is that how you say hello?
That's my name.
Oh! I'm sorry. You're like a black ghost.
This is my cousin.
Is that racist? Mm-hmm.
Greetings.
Over the course of 7 marriages, I've amassed 32 stepchildren. And obviously, Amber's my favorite. She's going to photography school.
Oh, that sounds interesting.
Keep it in your pants, Winger. You're embarrassing yourself. She may be hot, but she's my princess.
Step princess.
Gross.
Okay.
Yeah, they're just being 2 rambunctious boys.
Right, and then but
very
they're
normal.
And then but then Abed's dad's also there, and he kind of like doesn't one have to do.
He's a very no nonsense, very disciplined oriented kind of human being. Mm-hmm.
And then we meet Abed's cousin Abra, who's like in the full. Is it Abra or Abra?
I doesn't say there. It sounded like Abra.
Abra, yeah.
Abra,
yeah.
So
and she's in like a full burqa.
Yes.
Which full, a little bit we're veil. A little bit racist with.
There's yes. Well, yes.
Yes.
Shirley's very much coming into her own of being like the very religious Christian mother type, because we saw that in the last episode as well, where she made a lot of commentary about, like, you know,
Troy and Hobbit.
Very anti-homosexual commentary. That's supposed to be funny, but so, yes, and
then also
doesn't know how to react to people of different religions.
Right.
Wow, I can't believe Starburns isn't a virgin. But judging from that Bluetooth headset, his son is cha-ching! Winger! Too cool for family?
Everyone here is my family.
I love when they do that to him.
My older brother will be at the barbecue, and it's none of your business, but I ate my twin in utero.
Mazel tov.
Hey, Phantom Menace, how's a trade embargo with the Naboo? Anyway, broke the piggy bank of the escort service this time.
Hey, Duck Sauce, that was rude. The call girls I frequent are not nearly as attractive as my daughter.
Stepdaughter. Technically, ex-stepdaughter.
Also, Ken comes in and he kind of is making jokes towards everybody. Like, apparently Starburns has a kid, and he's, like, very... I like the kid that they got.
Oh, yeah.
Because he's, like, very, like, good at, like, impersonating the actor. And then, also make he also is racist towards Abra.
Yeah.
And also kind of assumes that it's funny because he assumes that Amber would be an escort, and then Pierce is like calls her for, like, says that she's prettier than a hooker, and we're just kind of like,
No, that's not how you compliment your stepchildren. The very funny thing is that I'm not sure if his commentary is directly related to anything, but it is very reminiscent of some things that came in later years with prominent people in the news making really weird ass comments about their children. So it's very funny. That's all I'll say about that. Because that was in my mind the whole time. I was like, this is very funny in the wake of like the last 6 years.
Good times.
Good times.
So then we kind of like have like the plot starting to split off. So it's going to be Shirley and Abed, Jeff and Pierce, and then Britta and Troy.
Yes.
So I'll get to, I think the first thing that comes up is like Jeff and Pierce. We'll do that a little bit first. Mm-hmm. But
your mother, April.
Wanda. Her name
is Wanda.
Yes. Amber's the best shot I'll ever have. Something like a real daughter.
Aww.
Striking out.
Have you told her she's prettier than a hooker?
If you come to the barbecue, and I know you'd never think of touching her, say a couple of cool things about me.
You want me to wingman you with your ex-stepdaughter?
I'm sorry. I got a thing.
You can't holster it for a friend.
Please, Pierce is barely a friend, and he's no more related to Amber than you are, and he was a total jag about shutting me down.
How much effort do I rate?
For you? I'd break a light sweat.
Good, I'm in favor. Help Pierce with his stepdaughter?
You're becoming dangerous, Annie. Just those doe eyes. Disappointing you is like choking a little mermaid with a bike chain.
Pierce wants to seem cool to his ex-stepdaughter. So he wants Jeff to hang out with him and like say some cool stories. Jeff doesn't want to, and then Annie basically guilts him into doing
right,
it.
Right, like he wants Jeff to basically wingman him to his stepdaughter.
Ex-stepdaughter.
Ex-stepdaughter. Very important distinction here. Yeah, and Annie does, like, guilt it.
That's, like, her job throughout this episode. Like, that's, like, what she's involved with.
Right. And I really... Annie and Jeff have a very fun kind of dynamic.
Yeah.
I like kind of like it whenever we explore that in any of the episodes. It's very short here, but, like, Jeff kind of, like... I think he has a bit of a soft spot for Annie. It's not very soft, but it's, like, soft enough.
I think
like,
it might
she
be...
She can, like, kind of twist the knife a little bit, and he's like, okay...
I think it's, like, the softest out for everybody, maybe, like, besides, like, I think he also has a soft spot for Abed.
Yeah.
So I think, like...
Yeah, right.
So then that kind of starts, like, their whole thing of, like, Jeff actually being helpful to Pierce, mm-hmm. and then Amber kind of, like, and they all get along.
Right.
So we'll stop there for a bit, and then we'll go to, because it was, like, a barbecue thing, and so then Abed and his dad and Abra are hanging out with Shirley and her sons.
Mm-hmm. Are you a ninja?
Oh, baby. Don't be rude.
Oh, she's wearing a burqa. It's a way for women to express their modesty. They're like Islamic turtlenecks.
Ask her if she has to play with us.
Yawadu alwaladu anya alama maita konti taridi alawaba mahum.
Fi waka al-amr lan umena idha araddu an akfisu kalilan fil bouncy house.
Uida adith al-nas.
That sounds heated.
She call a pig's anus or something?
Al-bayt al-mutati laysa bisatfa.
She's saying she's old enough to jump in a giant balloon. She's saying he's overprotective. Now she says he's a pig anus.
Stay put, boys.
Stop! Stop! Look at them. You are a bad mother.
Rude.
Oh, that's not nice.
Rude.
I go back to my car and get my emergency shirt. And I don't even like that shirt.
Then why'd you bring it?
Well, they always keep this shirt that, like, band, you can tolerate.
They got jealous and
like,
booted him.
Just
bring two nice shirts. The kids are, like, they're, like, also, like, probably not being the best, but they're kids, so it's, like, understandable.
They're being kids. They're being a couple of
They kind of want to, like, oh, why do you have to wear that? And then they ask her to go play, and she wants to go in the bouncy house. And then the dad's, like, no.
Right.
And she's kind of, and then they fight a bit.
Yeah, because he's just naturally very overprotective.
Yeah, and then, like, Abed is, like, rude because, like, the kid is just, like, the kids are goofing around and, like, they spill something.
Yeah.
And then he's like, you're a bad mother to Shirley. We're like, don't.
That's rude. Don't be rude.
Don't be rude. Mm-hmm. And then, I think before we get down, do you want to talk about Britta and Troy?
we should probably talk about
that. All right.
Is this Nana Barnes? Troy didn't mention you were such a knockout.
What's that supposed to mean?
Oh, come on. I'm sure you've broken a few hearts in your time.
Oh, tell me. How many men do you think I've laid with?
Who are you?
And I am sorry. Is there anything I can get you?
Yes. You can get me a switch.
A what now?
She's not family, Nana. You can't make her get you a switch.
She can make me get it. I just have to know what it is.
Oh, my God.
A switch is a stick she can use to whoop you with?
Don't do it.
Cherish, Britta. Cherish.
So, Britta's on her whole thing of, like, respecting her elders, but then we meet Troy's grandmother, and, like, she's kind of a bitch.
She's very a very hardened older woman.
Right. So then Britta is like trying to like be like oh like you must have like had a like I guess I try to be polite saying like oh you're very pretty, but then she's kind of like how many men do you think I've laid with?
Yeah, Britta's really trying to relate to her and like find something connect and really show that she's not writing her off because she's an old person. Mm-hmm. She's trying to be like, oh, we you know, forge a connection, do something. And it doesn't work.
Well, yeah, she offends her, and then Britta, like, realizes that, so then, like, she apologizes, and then is like, can I do anything for you? And then the grandma's like, you can get me a switch.
Oh, no.
And then she's like, what's a switch? And then Troy's kind of like, you can't, like, no, you can't do that.
Right.
But then Britta's like, no, it's okay, just tell me what a switch is. And then Troy's like, it's a stick so that she can whoop you.
Right, exactly.
So, no. And then, like, the fact that I was like, Britta doesn't have to do this, mm-hmm. but she kind of feels like she has to.
Because... Again, Britta wants to, she's trying to make a point, and she's trying to force that connection, and she just keeps getting herself deeper and deeper and deeper, and it gets very uncomfortable.
And then, like, the other bit is, like, her trying to find a stick, and then Troy's kind of like, stop.
Right.
You don't have to do this.
Like, why are you like this? Please cease.
And, like, Troy's right.
No, Troy is right.
Right. So, let's cut to, let's go back to Jeff and Pierce.
Off to the bathroom, stepdad.
Aww.
I've never been called stepdad.
I don't think anyone has.
Listen, let's get back. In fact, why don't you just leave now? I'll cut our work in half. Good luck, buddy.
Bye.
You're leaving.
My girlfriend is pregnant.
Pierce said you're gay.
Yep. As the sun rises, and I'm deeply ashamed. I'm just glad I have friends like Pierce to keep
looking for a new stepdaddy.
Oh no.
No,
oh, no.
Never again.
You mean the guy who decided he doesn't want men touching his ex-stepdaughter but who divorced my mom for our housekeeper?
Could be the same
Bear? Guy. Bear?
Yeah. Amber? Amber, there you are. Why are you here, Jeff? I go to school here, remember? I can't. Oh, come on, stay.
Stay.
I can't.
Maybe I shouldn't either.
Stay, Jeff. Sure. I think you have to. I'll stay.
Me too.
Hooray! So, again, like I said, everything's going really well. And then Pierce kind of says, like, all right, I think everything's going well. Jeff, you can leave. And he's like, all right. So, as he's leaving, he runs back into Amber. And then Amber kind of pounces on Jeff.
Yeah.
So.
She's like, hello.
So, hooray. So, Jeff can maybe get some.
Yeah.
And then they
rebound.
Rebound time.
Yeah.
And then, but then we realize, like, Amber really wants Jeff to stay, and then, like, he's not going to stay, then she's probably going to leave. So then Pierce is kind of like, all right, stick around. Mm-hmm. So we go play Pictionary.
They play Pictionary. It's fun. What a good, wholesome game. Family friendly and fun.
Well.
Circle. Circle with a squiggly line. Squiggly line, circle. You did hear me say circle. Smiling sideways vagina.
No.
Happy sideways vagina. Happy as a clam. What a gay guess, idiot.
Pierce, you're up.
Eat my dust, winger.
Mm. You do know we're on the same team.
Here you go. Let's see.
What? Pierce, you have to add more. Draw more.
Stop circling the same thing.
It's gonna get worse.
Guess something, you girlfriendless geek. What are you drawing? You're supposed to know, stupid. Relax.
Oh my god.
Yay.
I think the but we gotta take statements.
Cheng did the correct thing.
And I may just be a simple cop, but people need to know. This isn't going to stop until Pictionary bans the word windmill. Pierce?
Oh, my God.
We'll meet you at the gala. We're going to go get some coffee. Is coffee code for sex? Is it? No.
At first it is, because, like, Amber has, like, happy as a clam. It's funny. And then Pierce gets windmill.
Yeah. And so how do you draw a windmill? How do you draw a windmill?
Probably like a, like, I can't draw.
Okay.
So probably I would do like a circle thing and then like maybe a down thing and then just like out like a star kind of thing.
Okay.
And it'd be like some like fan things and then like that thing.
Okay. And I mean, is that not what Pierce does?
No, he drew a swastika.
It was so funny. It's, oh my god, this scene, we were absolutely rolling during the scene. I was rolling during this scene.
And then it keeps circling.
We're trying to like emphasize it, but it's only making it worse.
And then we should also mention this. I forgot to mention this. So yeah. Senior Chang's older brother comes, and yes. He's a rabbi.
Yes, right. So you have a like Rabbi Chang and Senior Chang, which there's humor here, and it's just they took very different lives, I guess.
That's fine.
They just went.
They seem like nice. They seem like the brother seems really chill, though.
He does.
But then anyway, so the brother sees what Pierce is drawing. He gets upset, and then Senior Chang is like defensive and like beats up Pierce.
Right. Exactly. So Senior Chang does come to the defense of his family, which is
right. And nice. Then they have like a big like assault thing, and then the police officer comes in. It's kind of like this. Like Pictionary needs to learn that they can't have the word windmill.
I thought you said that they like you know this is gonna escalate so we can't have the word windmill in the thick game anymore, which just the wording that was very funny makes me think of the internet
right. Anyway.
But it's yeah. So, who knew that windmills could escalate to hate crimes?
So then as that's happening, Amber and Jeff are like, okay, we're like you handle this. We're gonna grab a cup of coffee, and then the truth is like, is that a euphemism for sex? And they're like, no, but then it is, and they start to hide out.
The cop goes. Is it?
And then, so then, this kind of cuts to back to Britta and Troy.
Anna? Oh my god. this is so cringe.
Well, I'll make
do. Don't worry, it's not gonna get any worse.
Okay.
I'm lying.
I ain't no nun. Bend over. Drop your pants.
Oh my god.
Get over my lap. All you have to do is walk away.
Britta!
Oh, honey.
See, Troy, did you think I was a hypocrite? That I wouldn't really... Okay, how that... Ooh!
I don't understand you, Britta! I don't understand you at all!
You know what? Totally wrong room. Will you get the door?
The chaos is hysterical.
So they find Troy's Nana, and then Britta's like, I brought you a switch, and then she's like, that'll do. And then she's like, okay, because she figures, like, okay, just, like, on the hand, it's, like, whatever.
Yeah.
And then she's like, no.
She's like, I'm not a nun, but, yeah, I've heard, so you ever talk to somebody who went to Catholic school back when nuns could beat people?
Yeah, like my dad.
Yeah, my dad as well. My dad also has stories of being punched by a nun.
Punched?
My dad was punched in the face by a nun.
Oh, I didn't know the ruler thing.
Oh, that also happened, but apparently my dad had this story of one time my dad was a smartass, and he said something, and apparently he just turned around and like, punched him in the face, but she was a very tiny, frail woman, so didn't feel anything. He was just very shocked by the whole thing. So that is a story I will never forget about how my dad was punched in the face by a nun in grade school. Like, under the age of 13. God. So, yes.
But anyway, so then the nana's like, drop your pants and, like, bend over. And then Britta's, like, still kind of going with it. And Troy's like, you don't have to do this.
Like, she's already in too deep, though. Like, she's in too deep. Is. Like, but she could walk away at any point. But she's trying to make a point, and she's too dedicated to making the point where she just goes.
But then, like, because, like, she's dropping her pants, Troy's like, look away. Mm-hmm. So, and then she heads over and then gets beat.
Just well, then it's like this very like it's this very funny scene because there's one scene from Community that like I feel like everyone sees at least in GIF form of just like a lot of chaos going on at once. But this
is
also one of those scenes
where
just like there's so many things going on.
Right. At once. So like basically like the like Nana's like hitting Britta like pretty and like she's not liking it. She starts crying. Troy's also crying because he doesn't know what's going on.
Why? I don't understand.
Damn and then meanwhile, like, Jeff and Amber come in and they're about to, like, do it.
Yeah.
And then, like, they kind of see what's going on and they're kind of like...
Wrong room. And he's like, get the door. And so, like, he's literally walking out. She's, like, on top of him, like, being carried out. And she's, like, pulling the door behind. Which is a very funny detail.
So that was good.
It was the whole... The whole thing is really funny. It's just like this moment of like absolute chaos. Like the last episode, how we compare the two, where it's just a moment of unbridled chaos.
Right.
Very fun.
So then let's cut back to, I wrap up the Shirley and Abed stuff.
Mm-hmm. Oh, what a surprise that you lost them.
They're playing hide and seek.
Where?
I don't think that's how it works.
No.
Stop screwing around, Abby.
Hey, you want to yell at someone? Go find your crazy kids.
I let my kids be kids instead of acting like a jail warden.
Ah, you don't like a burqa.
I'm not talking about the burqa. I'm talking about her never having any fun. Now, Abra, you look me in the eyes and you tell me...
Fine. Now I'm the napkin man.
Nice.
Aw. Nice. I guess Shirley went away to get something, and then like she doesn't know where the kids, her kids are, and then she's like, "Where are the kids?" And then I was like, "Oh, they're playing hide and seek," and then we'll tell them. Like she's like, "I don't think that's how it works." And then her, like obviously he's mocking Shirley about like how she's not a good parent.
You lost your kids.
And then finally, like Shirley's had enough of it, and then like. She's, like, a kind of said of the way that Abed truth Abra is saying, like, not... She doesn't say the burqa. She says, like, because you won't let her have any fun.
Right.
Which, like, okay.
Yeah.
But then, so then, like, she's about to talk to Abra and saying, like, Abra, like, if you want to go play the bouncy house, you should. And then, like, looking at Abra and realizes, like, oh, wait.
That's not Abra.
That's, like, and then, like, Abra kind of looks at her. Yeah. And is like, mm-hmm. Yeah. And then she kind of distracts the dad real quick and then takes off the burqa and realizes that it's her kids.
Her kids. It's literally... Wait a minute, that's not a woman, that's two kids and a burqa.
Right, exactly that. And then they're like, oh, where's Abra? And then Abed points to the bouncy house, and she's on the bouncy house.
Right, yeah.
So it's kind of like, it's cute.
It's very cute.
And then later on in the student lounge,
Thanks for distracting my dad while we helped Abra get back in her burqa.
Well, if a young lady wants to go in a bouncy house, she should go.
It was a noble thing you did.
Oh, I didn't do it. No, it was Jordan and Eliza's idea. They're good kids. If they weren't, they wouldn't be able to help Abra. I see why you were so excited for me to meet them.
Aw.
You should be proud of them. You're a good mom.
Aw. Oh,
good boy.
Thanks, sweet. Look
what I got! Ding-dongs are my favorite.
The kids are still being kids and stuff, and then Abed comes up and says, like, his family left. Mm-hmm. And then he's like, oh, thanks for talking to my dad again while we got Abra back in her burqa. Mm-hmm. And then Shirley's like, yeah, no problem. You know, obviously, if she went to play the bouncy house, she should be allowed to. Like, that was a good idea. That was so sweet of you. And then he's like, oh, no, it was the kids. It was a legend Jordan's idea.
Yeah.
They're really good. And then Abed's like, they're really good kids. You should be proud of them. You're a good mother. And we're like,
oh, it's just a very sweet little thing.
That was actually really sweet of those kids.
It was. They were good kids.
It does end with them in a vending machine.
Yeah, but you know what? Sometimes that happens.
It does.
Sometimes that's life.
Meanwhile, back to Jeff and Amber doing it-ish.
Why do you have a $25,000 check from Pierce?
Tuition for fashion school.
Not photography school?
Maybe I'll just buy a car.
And you could just do that, huh?
Well, it helps that he's kind of desperate and stupid. Aww. Do you want to be a good person right now? Or did you want to be with me?
And then as they're doing it, Amber drops a check for $25,000.
Right.
And then we realize, like, oh, she's, like, kind of a grifter. Because, like, she mentioned that, like, she was going to photography school. Mm-hmm. But then she has the Jeff fashion school.
Yeah.
So we realize she just wanted the money from Pierce, like...
To do whatever she wants.
Right, because, like, yeah. She doesn't actually like him, but kind of feels like...
But wants to rip him off. Because, I mean, there is issues there, because Pierce wasn't a great person, so,
Yeah, and I'm like...
The relationship was a little sullied from the
start. So then Jeff feels bad, and it's kind of like, it cuts a bit, so you, like, wonder, are they going to do it or not? Or is he going to, like, have integrity?
Is he going to walk away, or are they going to do it?
Made me hang out with Pierce and his stepdaughter. She's grifting him.
She's what?
She's taking a bunch of money from him. He thinks it's for school, but it's for grifting.
Oh, Jeff! Gross! You're gross! You did it with her?
Yeah, but not twice. I wanted to do it twice.
That's
compromise!
Gross. You met her this morning. You're faster than some bacteria. Are you just doing this because Slater hurt you?
What? No, I'm not hurt. And Amber threw herself at me.
Well, you still have to tell Pierce she's taking advantage of him.
Pierce's getting a daughter, Amber's getting an allowance, I'm getting... Well, we already talked about it.
Wait.
But don't forget, this is Pierce. He's a racist...
Like the necklace.
...old goof. He does bad stuff all the time.
Well, sounds like you've got it all figured out,
is that considered a necklace, or...?
Why are you talking to me about it?
What?
Because...
A lie?
You're...
Okay.
Yeah, it's type of necklace.
Okay.
And you knew that talking to me about it would make you feel like a bad friend? And you wanted to feel like a bad friend because you want to be a good friend?
You really suck, you know that?
So compromise. He only does it with her once.
Even though he wanted to do it with her twice.
Right. So. And then Annie gets upset with him.
Yeah.
And then it has this whole thing of, like, you knew this was the wrong thing to do, which is why you told me about it, because then you would know it was the wrong thing to do, and she was kind of like,
Yeah.
So.
It's true.
Jeff knows he did something wrong, and then there's, like, a dance at the end of this, like, family day thing.
Mm-hmm. You were right. Nana's a monster.
What did you say?
I said you were a monster, ma'am.
And you said Troy was right. Get me a switch.
Okay.
He has to listen. Mm-hmm. And then also Brenda Frenzek back in the Troy and his Nana, and she's kind of like, you're right, she's the worst.
Yeah.
And then Nana's like, what did you say? And then she's like, finally willing to be honest with her. Mm-hmm. But then the Nana's like, but you said Troy was right. Get me a switch. And then Troy has to listen to her.
Right, because it's family. The things he do for family. Crazy family.
So that's the end of that.
Yeah.
And then meanwhile, Jeff runs back to Amber kind of saying, like, I want you to rub up the check and go dance with your stepfather. And she's kind of like, no.
Nah.
No.
Want to pick up where we left off after I log some time with Daddy Warbucks?
No, Amber. I thought about it, and what I want is for you to tear up that check and go dance with your stepdad.
If I walk over there and tell him everything, guess who he'll forgive?
You. But I'd rather be the bad guy than watch you siphon him.
I'll take the 25 grand. Over him, I take 25 cents. Bye.
But then she's like, all right, how about I take the check? And once the check clears, like, I just won't be around again. Mm-hmm. And then she's kind of like, he's kind of like, Jeff's like, you can be, but you need to be nice to him. And then she's kind of like, meh. And then leaves.
Yeah, she has no reason to. Like, she doesn't want to. So she's like, meh.
And then.
So she's not great. She has. Is there a history there? Sure. But I feel like nice.
Well, it's also like that one point where, like, they're in the hallway and they're talking and, like, Pierce says the name of her mom wrong.
Yeah.
So it kind of made, and, like, it's also, yes. Like, at the point when he says, like, oh, like, she left her mom for the housekeeper. Mm-hmm. So.
Which is a little messed up. But Pierce is, like, and it's kind of goes into what he says later, but he seems like he's trying to make up for one last time and two kind of right some wrong. So he, like, wants to establish a relationship at least. One of his stepkids, not quite working out well, but that's okay.
Right, but then he kind of, like, realizes that, like kind of knew, like, what the whole... He kind of knew the whole thing.
He kind of knew what was going on.
Listen, Pierce, I gotta tell you something.
She's not coming, is she? I wrote her a pretty big check this afternoon. I had a feeling she might take it and run.
You want me to help you cancel it?
Oh, hell, she earned it. Have a family. Share your life. That and understanding computers are two things you just can't... knock out at the end. Oh. Pierce, who did you call last week after you farted on Vaughn?
You.
And who did Abed call after that squirrel stole his hot dog?
Me.
That's sharing your life.
Aww.
If you have friends, you have family.
Yeah. And he's kind of like, whatever. Like, she did it. Like, it's fine. Mm-hmm. And then also, like, it's kind of like talking to Jeff, like, having a family and that kind of thing. And then, like, they have a hug and it's, like, nice.
Come here, son.
The slow rock.
Are we hugging or dancing?
You know, if the roles were reversed, I would have had sex with your ex-stepdaughter.
I did.
Chip off the old block.
Aww.
It's either that or deal with your actual pain.
Aww.
It's okay.
Aww.
Let it out.
I hate Glee.
I have no praise about Glee either.
I hate it. I don't understand the appeal at all.
I did like Glee, but I was also a teenager.
That is true.
That is fair.
So it was the hold it had on.
What? And then, like, there's also a thing of, like, Jeff, like, not really, like, talking about, like, the fact that he got dumped.
Yeah.
And then also, like, Pierce kind of, like, points him over and, like, so later, like, dancing with another guy. And then, like, Jeff puts, like, a puppy dog face and he starts crying.
Yeah, it kind of breaks him right, because that's... kind of what he does when he gets broken up with. He just, like, kind of shuts it down. He doesn't shut down, but he shuts, like, that part of himself down where he's like, I don't care. It's fine. I'm not bothered. And then it's like, we're going to just, like, crack that window open a little bit. And, oh, look, you are bothered. Wow, surprise.
And then he starts crying, saying, like, we always watch the show that she wanted to watch. I hate Glee.
Why do people I don't get the appeal.
If you're a teenage girl, you get the appeal.
Right. If you were going to high school in the late to early 2010s, late 2000s, early 2010s, like, that had a impossible hold on the population.
I keep, like, wishing that, like, I could actually finish that show and we could do it on this show, but, like, I don't know if I ever want
to. I think I would die. I know enough of what happens to Glee to be, like,
so do I. So I'm like, so
angry. I would be very angry, I think, a lot of the time.
Yeah, like, and I know, because, like, well, I watched the first two seasons, like, total. Mm-hmm. And even then, I was, like, there's, like, a bunch of stuff that I don't like. But, like, except for, like, there'd be points where I just, like, would fast forward just to get to the songs. And then, like, I watched, like, half of the third season, and then I got bored.
Yeah.
But again, I was 16. Right. And I was into theater.
Right.
So, like, perfect for me.
Made sense. Made sense.
But, like, it was popular for, like, I think for the first, like, three seasons, it was, like, everywhere.
Oh, my God. Yeah. It was impossible, and I didn't watch it. And I felt better about myself at the end of it.
Listen, you knew it was everywhere as a teenager when they sold Julie for it at Claire's.
That's true. That means you made it. You did it. Congratulations. What do they have at Claire's now?
When was the last time you were at Claire's? They had very cheap jewelry.
2020.
Why?
I needed some cheap accessories for a thing I was doing for work.
Okay. I think I remember the last thing I bought there was like a headband with like a little hat on it, and then I wore it to New York.
I got one on sale that said Happy St. Patrick's Day, and then I wore it this St. Patrick's Day. Actually, maybe I was there last year. It was either late 2020 or early 2021.
I do remember the second time that I went to get my ears pierced, because I don't know if I've told the story. I think I've told you a story where, like, the reason that, like, one of my earlobes is, like, a little bigger than the other, and that's because, like, when I was a kid, I kept my earrings in for too long, so the back, like, got into my skin.
Oh, no.
And then I had to go to the hostel to get it out.
Oh, that's terrible.
So then my hose closed up because I wasn't wearing earrings because, like, of that. And then I went to Claire's because I wanted to get my ears repaired, and she was afraid to do it.
Yeah, and that's fair because the girls who work at Claire's are not qualified to do that at all.
No.
No, so they're just, like, some, like, dumb teenagers. They're like, hey, you want a needle gun to stab a child? And they're like, here you go. That'll be $7.25 an hour. Insanity.
Right. So then I went to my pediatrician who did do it.
Okay. Oh, that makes sense. I used to still have the indents from where my ears were pierced. Oh, yeah.
I got a second little pierce, but that probably closed up because I didn't wear it. Like, luckily, like, I don't really wear earrings that much, but, like, I have, like, this one, like, one pair that I wear to look nice. So, like, I don't have to, like, force it in a lot of times, but, like, if I wear, like, so I think, like, if I wear those certain months so that, like, my ears say I still have a hole in them. Because I do like earrings.
Right. So
I think I did see, like, a TikTok montage of, like, kids getting their ears pierced. They're, like, really excited. And then, like, the click happens.
Oh. Oh. I remember that. I did get mine done at a mall kiosk.
I got my second one. They know. I think if you go to an actual jeweler, then they know what they're doing.
Right.
Just don't go to Claire's.
Just maybe don't get your ears pierced at Claire's. Nothing against people who work at Claire's.
But it's free. You don't have to pay for the earrings.
Nothing against the folks who work at Claire's. That's more about the business practice than anything. Yeah, oh, but, like, I also can't do certain metals in my ears or my ears swell. So, like, the really cheap, like, the nickel, like the
oh, see, if they get, like, good.
I have to do, like, gold.
Probably the earrings I have might work for you, because I got them from my cousin, and she, like, does, like, jeweler stuff.
My ears have been closed for, I stopped wearing earrings probably, like, 17 years ago.
Oh, okay.
So, yeah, 17 or 18 years ago, I stopped wearing earrings, so.
Yeah.
I would have to get them.
I think they're better. Do they ever wear, like, clip-on earrings? Like, they hurt.
I really like ear jewelry, where it just, like, hangs on your ear, which is really cool.
Yeah.
I don't do clip-ons.
They hurt. Especially, like, because I think of, like, Pretty Pretty Princess when you had, like, this.
They got it, and they were, like, jump. You know, they would, like, you would try to put them, and then it would fall off, or it would, like, have, like, this terrible grip on it. Very fun.
Community?
Community, yeah. I can't count the reasons
I should stay. What were you doing? How did we get onto earrings?
We're talking about
Glee, then we got to Claire, so we got to earrings.
Wow, that was a really fun. Thank you for joining us on that journey. We just looked at the map, and we're like, nah, we just kind of all went around it. It was great.
I will say this. If we can get it's probably because this won't happen. If we get 2,000 subscribers by the end of the year, we will promise at one point we will do Glee.
Oh, God. Not the whole. God, I cannot try. I can handle it.
Neither can I. We'll try.
Oh, God.
Some of the covers are fine. They were good singers.
They were good. They were talented.
A lot of them are Broadway, so.
Yeah, that's true. Anyway, all right.
Community.
We got to wrap this up.
That's the end of the episode. The end credits is trying up and get stuck in the vending machine.
Yes.
We do this again?
We thought it looked fun. Is your cell phone in your pocket?
Yeah, but I can't reach it. I can only move my right arm.
Okay, there's money already in there. Slide your arm through that bottom slot and press the buttons G14. When the snag is selected, the mechanical lever that's holding it will be thrust forward, thereby knocking your cell phone out of your pocket and into the receptacle below, where you can pick it up and call for help. Sorry?
I think I hit G13.
It's funny.
I think the trivia for that is, like, basically, because we'll get to it, but... what do you think of this episode?
No, it was a good episode. A little slightly more meat than the last one as far as, like, I feel like the plot wrapped up super quick in the last episode, but this one, it had some stuff to it. We got to explore some fun family dynamics, which was fun, but it was more for the family dynamics of people. I feel like the other characters whose families we didn't see probably have, like, some real complicated shit going on with their family.
I'm trying to think of, like, because I think... Yeah, and, like, yeah. You kind of, I'll say, like, you learn a bit more about it as the show goes on.
Yeah, so I have this feeling that, like, there's going to be more plot-heavy stuff with that. But it was really great to see Shirley's kids, because, like, her whole thing is that she's a mom. So mm-hmm. It was like, oh, she's being a mother. Abed's father we've seen before, so that was fun. But, yeah.
Like, that whole bit is, like, kind of, like, the sweetest part of the show.
Yeah, the whole, yeah, it was pretty chill. I thought Senior Chang's brother situation was very funny. Just because they went very different paths in life, but, like, it's supposed to be, like, equally funny. Anyway, but
Britta and Troy.
It's, I mean, respect your elders, I guess I'll say, but not if they're jerks to you.
Yes, I feel like respect people, right? Unless they're jerks to you.
Don't discount seniors because they're old.
Yes.
Be equally respectful unless they don't respect you. So, yeah. That's all I gotta say about
it. And if somebody, if an old woman asks you for a switch and you're not a member of her family, you don't have to get her a switch.
You don't have to subject yourself to a beating from a senior citizen or anybody. Please don't subject yourself to a beating from anybody.
Is it bad that the first time I realized, like, I ever heard the word switch was from Spring Awakening?
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Interesting.
Because they're German. Uh-huh. You ever see that? Or read the play?
I've never actually seen Spring Awakening, no.
I mean, I saw, I really, like, a bootleg, which I feel bad about. It's the one with Jonathan Groff.
Oh, no, yes. No, but you've told me about the plot of Spring Awakening before. Like, you've told me things about it, but I've never seen it.
There's, like, a point in the play where, like, Wendela, which I always said Wendela for a long time, but German, so. Mm-hmm. And she, like, finds out that, like, some of her friends' parents were, like, abusing them, mm-hmm. So she doesn't understand that. So then she asks Melchior, who's, like, the main guy, and, like, about, like, hey, can you, like, here's a switch thing, can you hit me? Mm-hmm. And then he doesn't want to, but then she begs, and he's like, okay, and then goes too hard, and then sad.
Oh.
It's okay, they forgive each other and have sex, and then horrible, and then tragic stuff happens.
Because remember, you have sex, you will die. You horrible, horrible, sinful heathens.
And they're German, so it's even worse. Nicht gut. But I feel bad, because I saw the bootleg version of it, but, like, how else am I going to see the show?
Yeah, well, there's a whole problem with it. I feel like they're like, you must go to the theater. And I'm like, okay, can you make the theater accessible for people to get to? And they're like, no, you have to go to the theater. And I'm like, oh my gosh. So, like,
I feel bad, but it's funny. I heard this clip with Patti LuPone, and she was like, I think she was a gypsy at the time. Mm-hmm. So she was, like, performing, and then somebody gets, like, taking, like, a picture and maybe a flash, and then she stopped the number, and she was like, no, we told you not to take pictures. And I'm like, fair.
Yeah. Yeah, well, don't be an idiot and put the flash on.
That's fair.
That's just you being an idiot. You brought attention to yourself. So.
Yes, don't do flash photography. Just make sure you're really quiet about taking
the... And who has the flash on their camera on anymore? And, like,
I sometimes do, but I don't actually realize it.
Okay. Mine is always on off.
I think it's off unless, like, I'm in a dark space.
Yeah.
So. Mm-hmm. But Community.
All right.
We're rambling right now.
We're rambling.
Do you want some trivia?
Yeah, let's go do some trivia.
So the pop culture references. There wasn't a ton of pop culture stuff.
Yeah.
Chang Myth references Star Wars. We're talking to Op-Ed's cousin.
Yeah.
Jeff mentions that Annie is, like not like doing what she wants to do. It was like choking Little Mermaid with the bicycle chain.
Yeah, it's kind
of
funny.
Shirley refers to her son Jordan as Andrew after the 14-time NBA All-Star.
Elijah, like, the prophet, and Jordan, like, the NBA All-Star. Perfect.
That's fun. And then the only other trivia was that they mentioned, like, and it's kind of, I don't know if it's, like, spoilery, but, like, the vending machine thing is kind of going to be referenced later on in the series.
Okay.
So, yes.
So keep in mind that there's a vending machine?
So, like, I guess I'll say, like, at one point, like, look at a fridge in an apartment.
Okay.
In season 3.
Okay, you got it.
It's like, so I'm like, really, like, if something's like, I don't want to spoil, not because of, like, plot points, just because of, like, references and gags.
Yeah.
Like, I guess with, like, Gravity Falls kind of reminds me of that thing. Like, oh, there's a lot of references and...
Yeah.
Gags and fun stuff. So, that's that. Are you okay?
Maybe. I'm not sure. But I'm having a good time.
I'm trying to remember. I think there's, like, a little bit of, I think, like, because I rewatched these episodes before we saw before today. So, I'm like, I think there's, like a sliver of a lull.
Yeah.
For, like, crazy craziness.
Yeah.
It's still good. But I think it's like a bit of a lull, and then it kind of gets back to crazy.
Yay, crazy.
Do I do a comment corner?
We're going to do a comment corner. Do I remember where we stopped with the comments?
See, the problem is that like we still have an episode backlog from the last time we recorded.
Yeah, so we just have to remember the date we last recorded. What was the date we last recorded, Dara? Somebody commented on a lot of our Gravity Falls stuff. Actually, yeah. We have a lot of Gravity Falls comments. For some reason.
Probably
we got a big Bacano comment as well. A couple Bacano comments. All right. Shout out to the Bacano folks. All right. I just wanted to say a quick shout out to Active Animals here, who I didn't really realize left a bunch of Bacano comments. So, like, sick.
Did they say anything good, or is it just kind of like, Bacano?
Bacano. So, not a bunch, but, oh my gosh. Are these really what we're doing? I think I'm back too far. I think I'm full of regret. I see. Did we read this comment? Because it's hysterical. This is not a community-based comment. But somebody started like commenting on some of our Legend of Korra stuff, and their comments are killing me. Like,
oh, was that the one they posted on Twitter?
I was like, I like this one. I think this person also. I think I posted two to Twitter because they were really weird.
I thought that was like an old one, but
No, this one was from a month ago. It says, "Why Korra Nasami doesn't try her luck with lots of men." Hey, I have a question for you guys. Why doesn't Korra and Asami try their luck with lots of men?
Because they want to do it with each other.
Yes.
And also, Korra and Asami tried that, and that was Mako. And that did not go well.
And which it shouldn't have, because it was Mako. Anyway.
I digress. I guess it's a bad botching Mako, because like, besides like the romance stuff, he was fine.
He was a fine character. He was a character that they just... He could have been written better.
Detective Mako was fun.
He was fun, but he could have been written better. And that's not all of his problem. Let's see. I'm going to read from, I guess we'll do 9 and 10. Let's see, 9 and 10.
Okay.
Yeah, that is exactly what we're going to do. We're going to read some comments from episode 9 of Community, episode 10 of Community. Let's see. Well, this one is in Spanish, and it looks like it's soliciting us. So it's talking about beautiful women, but it's not talking about us because there's a link to some other site that looks like it's probably going to put a virus on your computer.
So don't click it, anybody.
So let's see. This one was Debate 109 is the episode. Somebody left a comment kind of talking like a very long comment about like how we should change our format after like we had just talked about like why we do the format that we do.
I think I said, like, you might even get more than, like, 1,000 views. And I'm like, we have videos that have over 1,000 views. Not right. A community, but, like, still.
Right. This one was very funny. Like, the last thing says, you might even get more than 1,000 views. I was like, buddy, do I have I have some news for you. Look at our most viewed video. It has tens of thousands of views. But that's a thing.
I think with some comments later on, like, we could... I think we converted some people...
Wait, we did this because we do get comments that says like, okay, it was weird at first, but now it's fine. This one did get a lot of upvotes, but some at least commented be like, they talked about this.
Yeah.
They explained this in a video. So if you wonder why we do the things that we do.
I think it was football, feminism, and you. We talk about like why we do it in this format.
Why we have the format that we do. And it's worked for us mostly. So anyway, some also comments. I actually love debate class, though. Everyone hated debating against me because I always framed my argument predicting the counter arguments. Is that what you're supposed to do? I think if it works, it works. Because you're supposed to be able to account. You're not supposed to be easily rebutted, I feel like. Anyway, so Sabo the Hunter, who has become a frequent flyer of our community reviews. So like, hello, Sabo.
Hello.
We appreciate you. Says... despite the obvious age gap issue, I actually quite like Annie and Jeff's ship dynamic. It's probably the one I favor most in the series, even above Jeff and Britta. So, do you have any thoughts about that?
I'm trying to think if I don't. I think, like, that's how, like, a lot of people, like, I don't mind, like some stuff like that Britt and Jeff do is like kind of funny, but like they're not very good like romantic pairing, and like both of the dynamics I think are different enough, and I kind of enjoy both of them in different ways.
Yes, yeah, I agree, and it's funny because I had just mentioned this episode that like when they interact, like they have a really good dynamic that I enjoy. And Zum also says, I've never understood the age gap problem. I have a friend who's 32 and she's married to someone who's 74 and she's perfectly happy. So that's very interesting.
I kind of don't
know people with, I don't know a lot of people with large age gaps.
I think I saw this like one video. I forget the channel, but it was like this woman, she was like in her 30s and her husband was like in the 70s and like they seemed really cute. I think like, cause people say like, oh, there's like those like other worries about like they have like worries about age gap. And I kind of think like that's stuff that can happen in like any relationship. So, that's like, true. I'm kind of, like, if you're, like, in, if there's, like, an age gap, but you're, like, hopelessly in love and, like, everybody, and, like, everybody's, like, you do you, man. My thing is just, like, if you're a certain age and, like, there's, like, and, like, you're dating somebody and, like, there's a teen in their age.
Yeah.
That's my issue.
Don't do it.
Right.
Don't do it. Yeah. Yeah,
that's, like, my own, that's, like, honestly my only issue, but, like, and but, then again, like, I'm also, but, like, and also, like, make sure they're legal.
Yeah, like, let's do, yeah, let's keep it.
But like, if you're in an age gap relationship and you're like, oh, and you guys are perfect and in love, you do you.
Right. It's and it's very hard to make blanket statements a lot of time, like for things like that, like in providing with the pretext that it is like, you know, consensual,
right,
and legal. Then you know that's a hard thing to say because some people are very good together, some people are not, and that is so many different factors that go into that.
Mm-hmm.
But anyway, let's move on to episode 10. And read some comments from there. So we have Zom, Sabo, and... Oh, Suzanne's in a Sabo. Hey, guys, how's it going? I appreciate you. Zom says... an American Tale, back when kids' movies weren't afraid to scare you. So that's just Don Bluth for you, everybody. Don Bluth movies, very intense. Good stuff. I should go back and watch more Don Bluth movies.
I've seen Anastasia.
Yeah.
That's about it.
What are let's try to name
Secret of Nim?
Secrets of Nim. I remember seeing bits of that when I was a kid, and I want to go back and watch more. I want to really do an official rewatch of that because I remember seeing little parts and be like, what the heck is this? And it was slightly traumatizing. I did see an American Tale. I think I saw both of them, like, very, very
Thumbelina?
Thumbelina, yeah. But that was one of them. Ferngully? Is that Ferngully?
Don Bluth? I don't think that's Don Bluth. I don't know.
I think Ferngully's on with.
I feel like you would know this more than I would.
A Troll in New York City, I think, is one. I saw that in school. And, Titan A.E. is a Don Bluth, isn't it? Yeah. Nobody talks about that one. I thought that was a very interesting movie. I feel like that's very underloved. That's probably a cult classic at this point.
I think that might have been. I'm trying to think of anything modern animated movies that are terrifying.
I know. But it's different, though, because especially, like, when those movies came out, like, we were kids. Because I think Zom's around a very similar age to us. So, like, we were kids when those came out. So we had a different perception. There were some things that I was, like, terrified as a kid that I look back now. I was like, really? This was the thing that you were scared of? Yo, weirdo.
I joked that I was scared of Calabar in Halloween Town.
Yeah.
When he was, like, a monster person.
That's fair. And then watching it now, you're like, ah, that's funny. But, like, as a kid, you're like, oh, that's horrifying. I'm traumatized. Anyway. So it's very interesting. I'd be curious to hear what kids find scary these days when they're watching movies. Zom also says, After is a horrible series. I can't believe there's supposed to be up to 6 getting made. I don't think they're going to make all 6.
I thought there was just the 4th one that's coming out.
Yeah.
After Ever Happy.
Can I tell you the thing that I know most about that book is that I know, like, what happens in the full series. But the thing I know most about that book is that it was on the number one bestseller at every gas station we went to when I was in Germany back in college. That's really all that I knew about it at the time. And so it was an international bestseller. So it's not just the American.
I mean, I do find it interesting. Like, that's like out of these like sort of like fanficky books, like it's getting more than a trilogy.
Yeah. There's a lot of books.
I thought the 4th one was also like book and then there's prequels. I thought that was after that.
I don't think they're doing the prequel though. I don't think they would make the prequel. They couldn't make the prequel because it doesn't translate to a movie form. Anyway, I digress.
We're going to watch the 4th one when it comes out.
Yeah, we will. We will. It's a Patreon, everybody.
Patreon.
We have those on there. It's, oh, boy. Anyway, so, all right. So Sabo says, which one was this? This was environmental science.
Mm-hmm.
Sabo says, despite being the main storyline of the episode, I wasn't fully sold on the Chang story of this episode. Question for both: thoughts on season one happening almost entirely on Greendale and not exploring places that the characters may visit outside of college?
I kind of feel like that's most of. I get there are like some exceptions, but I kind of feel like that's most of the show.
Yeah, it's a bit, it, like to me that's just like the nature of a sitcom. Like a sitcom is like you have your set locations and like that's what you do. So like that seems very
in the realm of a normal show. Like with like other like sitcoms. Well, I guess like it kind of reminds me of anything. It more kind of like reminds me of. Like The Office and even mm-hmm. to an extent Parks and Rec, where like it mainly just takes place in like one area, like yeah. it takes place in, like the Dunder Mifflin office of like because I was thinking about like Friends, like How I Met Your Mother, and like they have their set settings, but there's like several of them.
Yeah,
but I guess like this kind of reminds like Community kind of reminds me of like a Office or Parks and Rec, where like they don't really diverge from like different places. Mm-hmm. It's mainly in like one area.
Yeah, I mean, I would say this closer to Office than Parks and Rec. Parks and Rec does go.
I believe you, but I didn't remember. I'm like, wait, do they?
No, Parks and Rec does. They kind of travel across the town a lot of the time. But, yeah, Office is very, like, set in mm-hmm. that location because that's the goal. And I feel like this is very much like that. Especially so far this season. It's been very locked to the campus. But I'm okay with that because, like, that just fits the show.
Right.
So, like, I'm okay with Community taking place exclusively on the community college mm-hmm. campus. But that works for me. Let's see. Any other comments? No, that's it. I think we'll stop there because we're going to divide them up real nice.
Well, that was long.
That was a good time. Good job, friends. We did it.
You okay?
I'm good.
No?
Maybe.
Yeah. Huh. Yeah. All right. Well, that's it for this episode. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed us, hello. And obviously you saw that we leave a comment because we do read them.
Yeah, we do.
So that's always fun. And please also subscribe because we're getting close to 770.
Yeah, we're 766.
If we get to 2,000 by the end of the year, we'll at some point do Glee.
Yeah, please get us to 2,000.
Maybe that'll be a Patreon thing. Like, if you're paid to watch Glee, will you watch Glee?
You gotta pay me a lot of money, so make sure that you sign up on Patreon.
Maybe that might be a Patreon thing. So like, comment, subscribe. Or dislike. I mean, it's still engaged. You engage with us.
Ha.
Maybe don't dislike because we don't like
all
that.
All publicity is good publicity. Ha. Fools.
We're on Facebook. Facebook.com/WittyClothes. Like us there. Leave a comment on our post. Mm-hmm. We're on Twitter @WittyClothes. Like our tweets. Follow us. Retweet. Yada, yada.
All that good stuff.
Excuse me. We're on Instagram and TikTok now. So follow us there. Leave comments. I don't know if you can leave comments on TikTok.
Yeah. You can. That's a big. It's a big.
I just scroll through some TikToks. I don't actually.
You don't actually. Yeah, they have comments.
My therapist told me to watch Noodles, which is I do on occasions.
Noodles. That's sure. That's fair. Good point.
She's like, that's how you follow. Like, she told me about. Like, I'm like, oh, there's some days I don't want to do anything, and she's like, then follow Noodles. And it's like, do the Bone Day thing, and I'm like, bone okay.
Bone day.
That's like plops.
No bones.
Anyway, mm-hmm. So there's that. I don't know how to do because like right now, like all the TikTok stuff is just like me like making videos of like from our. Like episodes, so like maybe at some point we'll do something goofy once in a while, but mm-hmm. we'll see. Also, audio wise, we're on Spotify and iTunes, so follow us on both of those.
Yeah,
rate, review, yada yada. We're on Patreon. Mm-hmm. If you want to get like more exclusive stuff, mainly right now we have our $5 level where you can get our monthly live stream where we might just have a discussion. Like the last one we did a discussion, we went through all of Goop.
Yeah,
which was fun.
Yeah.
I think it was funny. I was like, did I tell you? It's so good. Like, I was looking up like a shaker and I thought I could find a more expensive one on Goop than what I found mm-hmm. in the store. But it's a fun shaker.
Nice.
And then the last movie one we did, we watched The Second Degree in 65 Days.
Yeah, which was a heck of an experience. You guys should watch it.
So many montages.
Oh my God. It hurts me deep in my soul. But it makes for good entertainment to watch my suffering. Mm-hmm. So give us money.
Where nothing bad happened or everything bad happened?
Everything was terrible, but somehow not at the same time.
And there's going to be a third one!
Woo!
Let's listen to it. I don't think this one made the top 10 on Netflix like the first one did.
Oh, what a shame.
But the first one came out like pre-quarantine.
Yeah, so like what else were we supposed to do?
Besides watch porn,
yeah.
And then we're working on stuff for like the other levels. Like we're thinking like if there's like any shows that also a $5 member spinoff, first reaction or fan reaction. Mm-hmm. Right now we still have WandaVision stuff coming out. I'm trying to figure out stuff to not allegedly get past YouTube.
Right.
So we're doing that, and then other levels are gonna be like if there's like a show that doesn't fit the format, we might just like watch it there and talk mm-hmm. about it there. Maybe like do like live streams where we just like have like a meal together.
Not mukbang.
ASMRs. Mm-hmm. Just like whatever, goofy stuff, whatever we want.
Yeah.
If we get to 10,000 subscribers soon, we'll watch the Last Airbender movie. Mm-hmm. I still haven't seen it.
Ah, what a shame, but you guys got to subscribe to see that, because it's going to be a harrowing experience.
Yes.
Heck of an experience.
Yes. So that, I also have an email, awittyclothes@gmail.com. Email us all of your PG-13, at least, like, high PG-13 stuff. Yeah. And thank you so much.
Woo!
Join us next time. We're going to still be watching Community. We're wrapping up season one, actually, soonish.
Oh, wow.
We're going to be watching season 19, Beginner's Pottery.
Mm-hmm.
And episode 20, The Science of Illusion.
Oh, illusion.
Yeah.
Haha. Nice.
All right. So for a second fan reaction, I'm Dara Whitman.
And I'm Cailin.
Peace.
Stop pretending that my mean old Nana is awesome.
I'm not pretending.
Should we tell her?
I think it's cool that she's got her own style of discipline. Nana's old school.
Yeah, my mom told me there'd be white people that did this.
Pocket. She's visiting from Gaza.
Does she look like you, but in a wig and lipstick?
No, the Tally Berry. Mm-hmm. Everyone wears a full...
Welcome to Witty Clothes, but we're good at this.
No, not how that works.
Ready?
Oh, very good. Yes, let's talk about it.
Okay.